Welcome to a presentation on linear and angular velocity. The goals of the video are to calculate linear velocity and also to calculate angular velocity. So sometimes it is important to know how fast a point on a pulley or disk is moving or how fast the central angle is changing. These measurements are measurements of linear velocity and angular velocity. So you probably recall the formula distance equals rate times time. Well, if we let the rate r equal the velocity, we would have distance equals velocity times time, or d equals v times t. Now, if we solve this equation for velocity by dividing both sides by t, we would have velocity equals distance divided by time. And lastly, if we replace the distance with the variable s, we would have velocity equals s divided by t. And we use s when we talk about circles mainly because s is also used for arc length. Let's go ahead and take a look at a traditional question first. A runner of the Pat Tillman 4.2 mile race finished in 28 minutes 4 seconds. What was the runner's average velocity? So we'll take the distance and divide by the time.
This is an example of linear velocity.
The distance is 4.2 miles. Now the time is a mix of minutes and seconds. We need to convert these seconds into minutes. 4 seconds is 4/60ths of a minute, which equals as a decimal 0.06 repeating. So what we'll use for our time is 28.067 minutes. Here is the conversion of our seconds to minutes. Let's go ahead and divide and find our average velocity. Approximately 1.50 miles per minute, or 0.150 miles per 1 minute. Now this is our correct answer, but let's go ahead and convert this to miles per hours. So to convert minutes into hours, we know there are 60 minutes in 1 hour, so this is like multiplying by 1, except now the units of minutes simplify out. If we multiply across the top here, we're going to have 8.979 miles over 1 hour. And this is normally written as 8.979 miles per hour. On this next screen, I just listed some interesting linear speeds. You may want to pause the video and read these if interested. Let's go ahead and take a look now at angular velocity, and then we'll come back to linear velocity around a circle. So the measure of how fast the central angle is changing is called angular velocity, and typically they use the lowercase Greek letter omega. So omega is equal to theta divided by t, where theta is the measure of the central angle at time t. Theta must be in radians, and omega is expressed in radians per unit of time. So let's take a look at a problem. A mechanical arm rotates 1/3 of a rotation in 0.25 seconds. So we know our time is 0.25 seconds, but it states the arm rotates 1/3 of a rotation. We know a complete rotation would be 360 degrees, so 1/3 of 360 degrees would be 120 degrees. But we do have to express our angle in radians. I know that pi over 3 radians is 60 degrees, so 2 pi over 3 would be 120 degrees. And if it's been a while, the conversion would be multiplying by pi over 180 degrees. And you can check this, but it does come out to 2 pi over 3. So our angular velocity is equal to theta, which we said was 2 pi divided by 3, all over t, which is 0.25. Again, this was in radians. Okay, so we'll go ahead and divide to find our angular velocity. It comes out to approximately 8.378. And the units are radians per second. Okay, let's go back to linear speed and talk about how to find it around a circle. Remember the formula for arc length is s equals r theta. So if we go back to our linear velocity formula, we replace our distance s with r times theta. And if we wanted to, we could rewrite this as r times theta divided by t. And theta divided by t is actually our angular velocity, or omega. So there are a couple ways here to find linear velocity around a circle. And this is summarized on the next screen. So we have one formula for angular velocity, and we actually have three of them for linear velocity based upon what information we're given. Again, notice that theta divided by t is our angular velocity, and so you can see this here can be replaced with omega, or the angular velocity. And here we have the distance being replaced by the arc length for the distance around a circle. Let's take a look at a couple examples. A tire with radius 9 inches is spinning at 80 revolutions per minute. We first want to find the angular speed or velocity, and then find the linear speed or velocity. And depending on what textbook you're looking at, some use speed and some use velocity. Okay, so what we can gather from the given problem is that our radius is 9 inches. And if we have 80 revolutions per minute, that implies that our theta would be, well, each revolution is 2 pi radians. So we'd have 80 times 2 pi. So our angle is going to be 160 pi radians. So our angular speed or angular velocity will equal our angle theta, which is 160 pi, divided by our time. And it says 80 revolutions per minute, so our time, we didn't write down, is 1 minute. So that time isn't very exciting because this just makes our denominator 1 minute, which is our angular velocity. But let's go ahead and get a decimal approximation here. 160 pi divided by 1 would be 502.655, again, radians per minute as a decimal approximation. Next, to find the linear speed in inches per minute and miles per hour, we'll start with minutes because that's the given time. We'll go ahead and use this first formula since we already found the angular velocity. So our linear velocity is equal to the radius, 9 inches, times our angular velocity, which is here. And the units here are radians per minute. If we multiply this together, we will obtain 4,523.893 inches, or inches per 1 minute. And I'm writing it like this because I know I have to convert this into miles per hour. To convert the minutes into hours, we'll multiply by 60 minutes over 1 hour. This will convert the minutes to hours. And next, we need to convert inches into miles. It's going to take two conversions here. There are 12 inches in 1 foot. This will take care of the inches. Now we need to convert feet into miles, and there are 5,280 feet in 1 mile, and now the unit of feet is gone. Now the feet are gone, so now we just need to multiply across the top, multiply across the bottom, and then divide. So here it is in miles per hour, but now we just need to divide this to get miles per 1 hour. And I'm running out of space here, so I'll write that here, 4.284 miles. Okay, let's take a look at one more example. Raquel and Juan are on a merry-go-round. Rachel is 2 feet from the center and Juan is 5 feet from the center. If it takes 6 seconds to make 2 revolutions, determine the angular and linear velocity. For Raquel, the radius would be 2 feet and it's 5 feet for Juan. So I'll say r sub j is equal to 5 feet. Next, the time is 6 seconds and we need to find theta. If it makes 2 revolutions, well, 1 revolution would be 2 pi radians, so 2 revolutions would be 4 pi radians. I think that's all that we need to begin. Let's go ahead and reference our formulas here. The angular velocity, notice it does not require the radius, so the angular velocity is going to be the same for both Juan and Raquel. Angular velocity is equal to theta, which is 4 pi, divided by 6 seconds. So the angular velocity will be 4 pi radians divided by 6 seconds, which is approximately 2.094 radians per second. Linear velocity, notice that it does require the radius, therefore we're going to have a linear velocity for Raquel and also one for Juan. So let's find the linear velocity for Raquel first, and that'll be equal to the radius times the angular velocity. So the radius for Raquel was 2 feet times the angular velocity. And if we multiply this, we will have approximately 4.189. And for Juan, the only thing that's going to change is now is the radius is now 5 feet. And this product is 10.47. So we can see that even though they're on the same merry-go-round, since Juan is sitting further out from the center of the circle, he's actually going more than twice the speed of Raquel. Okay, I hope you found this video helpful. Thank you.